Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. My dear fellows and my respected teacher, Assalamu alaikum. Today I will present adjusting entries. What is an adjusting entries? Adjusting entries are changes to journal entries you have already recorded. Specifically, they make sure that the numbers you have recorded match up to the correct accounting periods. एडजस्टिंग इंट्री जो होते हैं वो होते हैं जो कि आपने पहले से ही रिकॉर्ड किए होते हैं। बाद अवकात एडजस्टिंग इंट्रीज गलत दर्ज हो जाते हैं या मिस्टेक हो जाती है कोई किसी वजह से, उनको जब दुरुस्त किया जाता है तो उसको एडजस्टिंग इंट्रीज कहते हैं। जनरल इंट्रीज ट्रैक हाउ मनी मूव्स, हाउ इट इंटर्स योर बिजनेस, लीव इट एंड मूव बिटवीन डिफरेंट अकाउंट्स। ओके, ये के किस तरह ये कारोबार को छोड़ते हैं और इनके दरमियान मुख्तलिफ अकाउंट होते हैं। हियर एन एग्जांपल ऑफ एन एडजस्टिंग एंट्री। इन अगस्त यू बिल ए कस्टमर $5,000 पर सर्विसेज यू परफॉर्म्ड, दे पे यू इन सितंबर, जो के आपने अगस्त में ये काम सर्विस सर अंजाम दी और सितंबर में पेमेंट की। इन अगस्त यू रिकॉर्ड दैट मनी इन अकाउंट्स रिसीवेबल एज इनकम यू आर एक्सपेक्टिंग टू रिसीव, देन इन सितंबर यू रिकॉर्ड द मनी एज कैश डिपॉजिटेड इन योर बैंक अकाउंट। टू मेक एन एडजस्टिंग एंट्री यू डोंट लिटरली गो बैक एंड चेंज जर्नल एंट्री। There are no eraser or delete key involved. Instead, you make a new entry amending the old one. Why make adjusting entries? When you make an adjusting entries, you are making sure the activities of your business are recorded accurately in time. If you don't make adjusting entry, your book will show you paying for expenses before they are actually incurred or collecting unearned revenue before you can actually use the money. So your income and expenses want to match up and you want to be able to accurately track revenue. Your financial statements will be inaccurate, which is bad news since you need financial statements to make informed business decisions and accurately file taxes. One more thing, adjusting journal entries are essential for depreciating assets, which is important for reporting tax deductions and balancing your books. How needs to make adjusting entries? If you do your own accounting and you use the accurately system of accounting, you will need to make your own adjusting entries. If you do your own accounting and you use the cash basis system, you likely won't need to make adjusting entries. No matter what type of accounting you use, if you have a bookkeeper, they will handle any and all adjusting entries for you. The five types of adjusting entries. If making adjusting entries is beginning to sound intimidating, don't worry. There are only five types of adjusting entries and the differences between them are clear cut. Here are descriptions of each type plus example scenarios and how to make the entries. Number one, accrued revenues. When you generate revenue in one accounting period but don't recognize it until a later period, you need to make an accrued revenue adjustment. Example scenario: your business makes custom to tie bags. In February, you make a $1,200 worth for a client, then invoice them. The client pays the invoice on March 7. Example, adjusting entry. February 27, accrued revenue debit, receivable revenue credit, 1200. Then when you get paid in March, you move the money from accrued receivables to cash. March 7, accrued debit, 1200 credit, cash debit. Accrued expenses. Once you have wrapped your head around accrued revenue, accrued expense adjustments are fairly straight forward. The account for expenses you generated in one period but paid for later. Example scenario. Suppose in February you hire a contract worker to help you out with your tote bag. You agree in advance to pay them $400 for a week and the work. However, they don't invoice you until early March. Example, adjusting entries. In February, you record the money. You will need to pay the contractor as an accrued expenses, debiting your labor expenses account. February 21st, accrued expense credit, labor expense debit. In March, when you pay the invoice, you move the money from accrued expenses to cash as a withdrawal from your bank account. Accrued expense debit, cash credit. Deferred revenue. If you are paid in advance by a client, it is a deferred revenue. Even though you are paid now, you need to make sure the revenue is recorded in the month you perform the service and actually incur the prepaid expense. Example, over the years, you have become well respected in the tote bag community. You are invited to speak at the annual tote symposium in Lodi, California. The conference showrunners will pay you $2,000 to deliver a talk on the changing face of the tote bag industry. They pay you in January. After you confirm, you will be attending. You will speak at the conference in March. Example, adjusting entries. Then in March, when you delivered talk and actually earned the fee, move the money from deferred revenue to consulting revenue. January 6, cash debit, $1,000 deferred revenue, $2,000 credit. Then in March, when you deliver your talk and actually earn the fee, move the money from deferred revenue to a consulting revenue. Deferred revenue debit, consulting revenue credit. Prepaid expenses work a lot like accrued revenue, except in this case you are paying for something up front, then recording the expenses for the period it applies to. Example, you are rent a new space for your total manufacturing business and decide to prepay a year's worth of rent in December. In December, you record it as prepaid rent expense debited from an expense account. Example, you are rent a new space for your total manufacturing business and decide to prepay a year's worth of rent in December. Expense account. Prepaid expense debit, cash credit. Then come January, you want to record your rent expense for the month. You will move January portion of the prepaid rent from an asset to an expense. Rent expense, debit, prepaid rent, credit. Depreciation expense. When you depreciate an asset, you make a single payment for it, but disperse the expense over multiple accounting periods. This is usually done with large purchase like equipment, vehicle, or building. At the end of the accounting period, during which an asset has depreciated, the total accumulated depreciation amount changes on your balance sheet, and each time you pay depreciation, it shows up as an expense on your income statement. The way you record depreciation on the books depends heavily on which depreciation method you use. It's a pretty complex operation involving large sums, considering the amount of cash and tax liability on the line. It's smart to consult with your account before recording any depreciation on the books. To get started, check out your guide to small business depreciation. Thank you for your time.